position. We're still working off this entry. Please don't get lost in this entry. I just chose this entry because we did this the most today. Right? You can do this from any position you want, especially if you believe you don't have the advantage. And if we're talking about predatory violence, predators don't lose for freedom. They picked you because they think they can take you. So they might have a size advantage or a weapon or friends. I always make the joke, if somebody Heidi size comes at me, starts lipping me off, I look for a weapon or friends, because that's weird, right? But if somebody huge comes at me, I'm like, oh, this makes sense, right? And they think they can take me.
Logical.
It's logical. So from this position now, there's a saying in the shooting world, and I'm not the best shooter, but I like the saying, so I'm going to steal it, which is, if you can't shoot and move, you can't shoot. It's the same thing with this. A lot of martial arts is done kind of in a position where we hit, and there's a lot of value in that, but if we don't break that model every so often, you get super lost in it, right? So the second that people go from hitting pads to sparring, they're like, what can I hit them? Says, oh, you gotta move your feet too, right? So all of a sudden there's a change that happens in that next cycle of the drill. So same thing when we're doing this, I want you to follow your partner. We're gonna do a room setup for this for safety in a second, but I want you to, now when you're here, your partner's just gonna be a meat puppet. They're just gonna react. Their goal is just not to fall down, and you're not gonna take the person to the ground yet. That is not in the goal set. If it happens by accident, I understand, but it shouldn't happen by accident two times, right? So as we're doing this, we get to this position, okay? We're gonna be throwing these short shots. The only time I want your partner to intervene is if they feel a break in this framework, okay? Because again, if you don't know you're doing it, then you don't see it, right? And the second they stop you, just end the drill. It's not a time to fight or spar out of this. It's just an indicator that you started taking bigger shots and now you're like, ah, okay. I just lost the goal of this. Because some people are still doing it, and of course you are. That's what martial arts is. You want to throw the force, and we will. Trust me on this. We'll get there. But right now, I want these shots just really tight. But if Kasey feels this, he can just put his arm in the way or whatever. And that's realistic. If Kasey's messing me up, right, he's winning. But now he's not winning anymore, right? Because I could get my... The thing we're going to show you, I can then activate. If you don't know how to beat your system, you don't know your system. Right? So from this position, as I'm here and I'm hitting and making this impact, I can't get into this position unless they're like seriously, and you're like, aha, finish him. That's fine. So from here, one, two, three, you're gonna move your partner just across the room. And if you do this, your partner's gonna be aware, which means you don't turn your brain off. There's no wasted training time here. You're being overwhelmed. You're like, well, please don't do it. If they get you to the wall, they did a great job. If you interrupt them, you rotate. So let's get the groups over here. We'll do three separate lines, please.